Hey guys, welcome to part 4, Let's Play Legend of Zelda the Minish Cap, brought to you by GameOne.com. This is on the last part, we just entered the Deepwood Shrine, and now we're going to figure out where we're supposed to go next. This way, maybe? Well, I guess we'll find out. Let's see. Let's try this door. Downstairs. Wait, there's a chest there. How do we get to that one? Wait a minute. I know. I think I know how to take care of this little problem. I was to push this one first, then this one, to get the compass. There. But what to do with this chest? I'll figure it out later. Now there's a puzzler. I suspect there's not much more we can do right here. Let's press on. Perhaps we can work this from another angle. Actually, that's a pretty good hint telling us that we can't solve this puzzle here. We'll have to do it somewhere else. I mean, that sounds fair to me. It's a good way to use strategy. Okay, now we're back in this room. Oh, rogue mushrooms. What else is over here? Oh, can't do anything here. I don't have the key. There's another heart piece up there too. Okay, now we're back here. What if I went that other way that I skipped? I have a feeling that's where I was supposed to go in the first place. Ah, damn, I went too far. Usually the track marks are a pretty good clue to how far you need to go. There are no track marks here, so I'll do this. Oh, nice, that worked. Alright, now let's see what's beyond here. More slugs, yay, what fun! Surprise slugs! Coming from above. Okay, I think I'm gonna have to do something about this statue. I'm not gonna put you over here, I'm gonna put you over here. I'm gonna use the other statue to hold the switch down so I can get through. So if I use that statue on the right to hold down the switch, I still gotta worry about this statue and it's gonna be in the way. Uh-oh. Epic battle with three not-so-epic enemies! That epic music was misplaced. Believe me. At least now I got that key. Okay, this is... I was supposed to go down in the first place. I basically just went around in a circle that I shouldn't have. Doesn't matter. This stuff slows you down. I hate it. What isn't it, anyway? Looks like brown flour. Or something. Okay, here's a mini-boss. You gotta attack the head so you can attack the tail. It reminds me of a Wiggler in some sense. It gets aggressive when it's red, and not so aggressive when it's blue. Well, Wigglers are usually when they're yellow, they're not so aggressive. But you get the idea. But yeah, this is a very easy mini-boss. I don't see myself getting hit at all. I don't think it would have anything... any characteristics like the Moldorm from Legend of Zelda lore, because Moldorm was very annoying. I hated that mini boss. Oh, the gust jar. I can use that to suck stuff. I mean, you know, just suck stuff in and blow it out. What if I took, like, every single one of these webs? Just to see if I find something. It gets more powerful after a little while. You know, just to keep it clean, you know? I might be able to find a little secret. Come on. Okay, I know I can go this way, but I was already there. This is where I needed to go to get a heart piece. Plus, the gust jar cleans up all this dirt. That's perfect. That allows me to uncover some hidden stuff that could be hidden underneath these. Plus, it takes care of these mushrooms, too. You can suck on the red stuff. It turns them gray. And that means you can hit them with your sword. Ooh, 10 mysterious shells. More on those later. We'll deal with them after a while. But now's not the time. Okay, let's keep looking around for some hidden switches. There's probably some somewhere. That'll help you find treasure. And I can take care of those webs as well. Ooh, I activated a teleport! How about that? What could this mean? The teleporter leads directly to the heart piece. That should help me out. Do I get anything for killing all these enemies? Probably not. Oh well. I guess I can just go back down. Well, if I remember correctly, this had a web too. There. I'll go in this little hole. What can go wrong? Okay, I gotta use the guest jar to bring this lily pad over. Now what? Unless we find a way to travel by water, we won't be going much further. Yeah, you pretty much gotta use the gust jar to steer the lily pad the entire time. For some reason, I find this very tedious, especially when there's enemies there. Like these little flies, even if you hit them, they can actually keep going. I can't tell if I'm going the right way or not. I'll give it a shot. Oh no, I'm not going the right way. I need a key. I mean, it looks like I'm fucking the jar. I mean, look at it from the side, like, ugh. Like, Link's blowing his load. Is this the right way? Oh, yeah, but have to... Oh, great. Need a barrel. This'll do. Yeah, now I can go across. Wait, I remember this room. Wasn't this the room that I couldn't solve earlier because I was not at a good angle? The barrel's still there, too. Perfect. Okay, time to go back to that locked door. Now that I got a key, I can go in. Yeah, you stay down, stupid gate. You know who you're messing with if you try to keep me out. Too bad Link can't do this diagonally or something. Stupid slugs. There, now let's see what's in here. Gotta do this. Oh, well, at least I can use the mushroom to help me out. Suck it in, and then it'll blow me out. That sounded kind of wrong. Suck me in, blow me out, mushroom lady. Ooh, big key! Okay, there's the teleport. Okay, before I go down any of these stairs, let's go in the blue teleporter. To get a heart piece, of course. There, I got a new heart container before I even fought the first boss. How about that? It's almost like Zelda 1. What if I went this way first? Can I get that treasure? Oh, yes, I can. That's all I got, 20 rubies. I guess I was supposed to go the other way to get to the boss. Well, yeah, I can do that. You know, I'm not gonna complain. At least I got 20 rubies out of it, but, you know. I would like to not have to switch ways. Okay, I gotta use the guest jar to bring you over this side. And then go around here. There, it's that simple, really. Okay. Time to see who the first boss is, and believe it or not, is a natural enemy. That, of course, is bigger than us now. Not like, really, we're just smaller. It's a green choo-choo, and that's the first boss of the game. So, I've run out of time. I'm not going to have enough time to show you the boss battle. But in the next part, we're going to take out the green choo-choo. This is going to be one hell of a ride. See you later, everyone.